So why do low-carb diets work? The way I often hear it explained is, basically, if you cut the carbs out of your diet, then your body has to go looking elsewhere for its energy source, and it goes to look for your stored body fat, and that means that you lose weight. But actually, I think it goes a little bit more in depth than that, and that's what I'm going to cover in this video. So let's get started. Hey Carb Dodgers, my name is Dr. Dan Maggs. I make videos all about how to sustainably lose weight for the longer term. And that's all about low carb diets, ketogenic diets, intermittent fasting, exercise, stuff like that. I make new videos every Tuesday. So if that kind of stuff is of interest to you, then why not subscribe to my channel? Just hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell if you want to get notified whenever I upload a new video. So this week we're talking about why do low carb diets work? And they do work. I think we've got an overwhelming body of evidence to suggest that they do now. Currently, compared to low fat diets, low carb diets are winning 33-0 in terms of statistically significant weight loss in randomized controlled trial studies. Those are the gold standard of studies. So why is that? Well, first of all, it's because the conventional approach is simply flawed. The conventional approach that you'll no doubt be familiar with is the calories in, calories out approach. Basically, you're consuming too many calories and not burning enough calories, so you gain weight. And of course, the solution to that is to simply eat less, move more, create a calorie deficit, and in the longer term, you're gonna find that your problems are solved. Except, it doesn't really work, does it? Because most people have real trouble sticking to a weight loss program. Most people who do stick to a weight loss program lose minimal weight. Even if they do start to lose some weight, then they're probably gonna put it back on within a year or 2 years. And the reasons are because our body fights back when we calorie restrict it. Our bodies aren't stupid. We get more hungry and we reduce our metabolic rate. So you start to actually feel tired and you start to feel really, really hungry. It's no wonder that people fall off their diets really quite quickly. But I believe these issues are properly addressed by the low carb approach, because the low carb approach deals with things on a hormonal level rather than just basically thinking with just large energy stores. And I always encourage people to go back to basic biology and really think about what the human body is. And really what the human body is a series of tissues and organs. And the way those tissues and organs communicate with each other is either via the nervous system or via hormones. And it's hormones that we're gonna focus on in this video, because that's what is really, really important in terms of why low carb diets work. So number one, low carb diets reduce insulin levels. Now, it has an impact on a number of different hormones, but insulin is really, really important because it is our body's fat storage hormone. And what I mean by that is it actually is the signal to take glucose from our bloodstream, put it into our cells, into our fat cells, where it is turned into our stored body fat. And insulin is produced by the pancreas in response to elevated blood glucose levels, which shuttle that glucose from the bloodstream into the fat cells where it is stored. So elevated insulin levels equal fat storage. And low carb diets address this because low carb diets reduce insulin production. It's the carbohydrates, particularly the glucose, that signals to the pancreas to produce more insulin. If you take away the carbs, the insulin production is lower. And those lower levels of insulin allow our bodies to access that stored fat rather than just storing more of it. And this results in weight loss in two phases. In the first few days, you're gonna lose mainly just water weight, and I'll explain why that is in a second. But after a few days, you're gonna start to be able to access those fat stores and actually use up that body fat for energy to supply your body, and you'll lose body fat. So very quickly, the reason we lose water weight in the first few days is because insulin also has an effect on the kidneys, causing them to retain fluid. Lower levels of insulin mean that the kidneys can lose fluid. That's one of the reasons why our blood pressure can go a bit lower when we're on a low-carb diet, which is generally thought of as a good thing. The second reason is because our bodies store carbohydrate for the short term in the form of glycogen. Now, glycogen is stored in the liver and in the muscles, and along with glycogen is stored water. So you start to burn through those glycogen stores, and after a few days, you will have burnt through them, but you'll also have lost the water that was stored along with them. And the low-carb diet is particularly important for people who are suffering with something called insulin resistance. So insulin resistance is where the body is actually resisting the effects of insulin. So it takes more insulin to have the same effect on the cell, which is to move blood glucose from outside in the blood into the cell itself. And many of us who struggle with obesity have also got insulin resistance. The two really go hand in hand. And that means we've got a lot higher insulin levels a lot of the time, and therefore are turning off our ability to break down fat. The second reason that low-carb diets are so effective is because of reduced appetite. Now, appetite, again, is under hormonal control. There's lots of hormones that are involved in appetite, but hormones like leptin and ghrelin. Now, I don't want to go too much into those hormones here, but the sense of fullness that you get on a low-carb diet is very, very different from the sense of fullness you get on a high-carb diet. The high-carb diet is very much about the bulk of food that you eat. So you're full because you really can't eat any more, and the stretch receptors in your stomach that are telling you that you're full. Whereas on a low carbohydrate diet, you feel a lot more full because you are nutritionally satisfied. Particularly proteins and fats are very filling on their own. Whereas carbohydrates, like I say, are really due to the bulk of the size of the food. And it's very common for people who are suffering with obesity to tell me that they're hungry all the time. I remember back when I was struggling with my weight that I couldn't fill myself up at breakfast, not for very long anyway. No matter what size of bowl of cereal I'd have in the morning, and I had some pretty big bowls of cereal, I couldn't really fill myself up until gone 11 o'clock in the morning, when I'd have a dip in energy, and I just need to eat something in order to keep me going until lunch. And it would be the same thing in the afternoon as well. Despite however big a lunch I'd have a dip in the afternoon that I'd need to go and grab something, usually a sweet treat, so I could function until the evening when I would have my evening meal. So this is very, very common. People tell me that whatever I eat, I seem to be hungry fairly soon afterwards. And guys, if that's something that resonates with you, then please let me know in the comments down below this video. I'd love to hear from you on that. And the reduced hunger that many people feel on a low-carb diet is a gateway into intermittent fasting, which, as you may be aware, is an excellent way to lose weight. Many people simply don't feel hungry in the mornings when they've been on a low-carb diet for a few days or a few weeks. And if you start tuning into your hunger, then you don't really want to eat until around about lunchtime, which means you naturally fall into a pattern of what we call 16-8 intermittent fasting, which is when you really only eat within an 8-hour window. You may eat a larger lunch and a larger dinner, maybe 7 o'clock in the evening. And that means you are actually fasting for a total of 16 hours overnight. And intermittent fasting is great because throughout that fasting period, your insulin levels are going to be low and you're going to be releasing your body's stored fat for energy. And the third reason that low-carb diets are so effective is because they appear to give us a metabolic advantage. There was a fantastic study done in 2018 that I'll link that down below this video. And what they did was they put several groups of people onto different diets in terms of carbohydrate content and looked at the metabolic advantage of each of the diets. And what I say by metabolic advantage is that the low carb diet group actually burnt 200 calories a day more than the high carb group. So yeah, a pretty significant metabolic advantage simply by being on a low-carb diet. You're going to be burning about 200 calories a day more than somebody who's on a high-carb diet. And the final reason low-carb diets are so effective, and we're starting to see more and more evidence that points towards this, is that low-carbohydrate diets help with food addiction. Now, I don't want to go into why sugar and carbohydrates are obviously so addictive at this point in this video, but I've often hear people saying, oh, I could never go without pasta, I could never go without bread, I could never go without rice, or I could never go without cake. And on a certain level, that's addiction. Compare that to, I could never go without alcohol, or I could never go without cigarettes. Well, you'd easily say that that was addiction, wouldn't you? And it seems that less food addiction equals less consumption of these bad foods, which are obviously high in energy, therefore improve weight loss. So that's it really. I think it all comes back to hormones at the end of the day. And I think understanding that our bodies are not just an energy store, which needs to be calorie restricted, but a series of interconnected tissues which communicate via hormones. And if we actually work with our body's hormones, then we're gonna be onto a winner. And that's really the basis of why low-carbohydrate diets work. Okay, that is about it for today's video. Thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by giving it a thumbs up. And why not leave me a comment to let me know what you thought. So that is about it from me for today. Thank you ever so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. If you've enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up, hit the like button, and I'd love to hear from you. Leave me a comment down below. Like I said at the beginning, I release new videos every Tuesday. So if you want to find out more about those, then please hit the subscribe button, and hopefully I'll see you next Tuesday.